Hello, this is a presentation on our 4-stroke petrol engines. In this section, we are going to study how 4-stroke petrol engines work. So as you see in this schematic and also the adjoining diagram, why we call it as a 4-stroke engine? A 4-stroke engine produces one power stroke for every 4 strokes of the piston that it traverses. So one stroke means the movement of the piston from one end of the cylinder to the other extreme end. So when the piston completes its traversing 4 times, only once the power is produced inside the cylinder. So to understand how it runs, first we have to go through the terminology as to what are the different parts and what are the associated things that come into picture. We can see in this picture over here, the main part being the piston that is running inside, that is traversing inside a cylinder. The piston is connected by a connecting rod through to a crankshaft, which is basically the output of the power of the engine. So in order for the working to happen, we have inlet and outlet valves that is are also called the mixture in valve or called intake valve, and also the exhaust valve. And encircling around the cylinder is a cooling water which will remove the heat as and when required. And at the top of the petrol engine, you can see a spark plug which is used to ignite the mixture. Some of the terminology associated with this IC engine is, one is called as a bore, which refers to the inner diameter of the engine cylinder. And it can also be called as the diameter of the piston itself. So more or less they are very close to each other with a very close tolerance fitting between them. So the piston is going inside the cylinder, the bore being the gap in between which the piston will travels. So coming to the stroke, it is a linear distance traveled by the piston when it moves from one end of the cylinder to the other end. And for every engine, there is a top dead center and a bottom dead center. So that is the topmost position a piston can achieve and the bottommost position a piston can achieve. So the traversing, the length of traversing between those two is called as the stroke. The top dead center is extreme position, and the moment we mean top, it houses the cover of the engine and also the inlet and exhaust valve and also the spark plug, whereas the bottom dead center is open and it is next to the crankcase or the vessel in which the entire assembly is housed. So what are the 4 strokes of a petrol engine? So you can divide them as a suction stroke, a compression stroke, power stroke and an exhaust stroke. So what happens in each stroke we will study. So in the suction stroke, thinking the cylinder is in idle position without having a power of its own, the inlet valve is open and exhaust valve is closed. So during this inlet, air and fuel mixture, that is petrol and the air mixture through the carburetor is coming in the cylinder through this intake valve. So inlet is open, and at the same time we can see the exhaust valve is closed, and the piston is moving from the top dead center to the bottom dead center. So it's like a sucking action as the piston moves from top dead to the bottom dead. So all the mixture is let inside the cylinder due to the pressure difference or vacuum that is created inside the cylinder. And so this, since this sucks the air and fuel mixture inside the cylinder, it is called as the suction stroke. And at the same time, the crankshaft revolves half the rotation in its entirety, and the energy required for this stroke is supplied by the cranking. Mostly nowadays it is supplied by the use of an electric motor. Coming to the next stroke, whatever mixture is inside is to be compressed. So in order to have a compression, the cylinder volume inside must be reduced without having any amount of fluid to escape. So in this position, both inlet and exhaust will be closed. This corresponds to the other half of the rotation which was pending for the cycle to complete. So the piston moves from the bottom dead to the top dead center, and the mixture which is inside is getting compressed due to the stroke, and hence it is called as a compression stroke. Again here the energy is supplied by the cranking, and the petrol and air mixture is compressed to a ratio of at least 1:11. And this mixture at the end of the compression stroke gets ignited by the spark plug. So the spark plug essentially is a electrical device in which the electrical coils will give it a large amount of potential difference, which produces a small amount of spark and which is enough to ignite the mixture. As soon as the mixture ignites, the hot gases, the combustible gases, try to escape in all the directions, whereas the only direction which it can move is to move the piston down. And that is when we have the power stroke, the power that is developed by the combustion of petrol and air mixture. Or in other words, the energy that the engine is getting is from this power stroke. So the piston moves with a great force from top dead center to the bottom dead center, and during this stroke again the crankshaft is revolving one half of the rotation, and the burnt gases force the piston to move down. And finally we have the exhaust stroke, wherein the piston moves back again from the bottom dead to the top dead, completing the one full rotation of the crankshaft. At the same time, when it moves from bottom dead to top dead, the exhaust valve is opened at that moment, and whatever the combustible gases were there inside are expelled out of the cylinder through the chimney. And the energy for this stroke is supplied by the flywheel which is attached to the crankshaft.